Hello dear students, welcome to part 1 of UGC NET Environmental Sciences syllabus review, where we will be reviewing the syllabus for the UGC NET exam for the topic Environmental Sciences. I also welcome you to www.evsgogreen.com, the premier channel for environmental science lectures. Please do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Now let's begin. So as you can see, there are totally 10 units in the UGC NET Environmental Sciences topic. The first unit is Fundamentals of Environmental Science. The second unit is Environmental Chemistry. Third unit, we proceed on to Environmental Biology. Then we have Environmental Geosciences, which is a bit of geosciences. And then we have the fifth unit as Energy and Environment. So we have 5 more units. So these are the first 5 units. The next 5 units are Unit number 6, we have Environmental Pollution and Control. Unit number 7, you have Solid and Hazardous Waste Management. In Unit number 8, you have Environmental Assessment, Management and Legislation. In Unit number 9, you have Statistical Approaches and Modeling in Environmental Sciences. And in Unit number 10, you have Contemporary Environmental Issues. So in this part, part 1, we will briefly go into the first unit, what it contains, and the subsequent video lectures will have the review of the other units one by one. Okay, so in this unit you can see all the 10 units here. So these are the units from 6 to 10 and these are the units from 1 to 5. Okay, so let us proceed to the first unit. See, if you look at the first unit, is the introductory unit. It says about the fundamentals of environmental sciences. So here it starts with, I have split it into an easy to understand format so that it is easy for you to follow. And let us see the aspects of it. Environmental sciences, you have to define the environmental sciences. What is environmental sciences? Sum total of biotic and abiotic, etc. Then you go for the principle, then the scope. So definition, principle and scope of environmental sciences forms the first part. Then once you go through that, then you go to the structure and composition mainly of the different components of the environment, physical environment, mainly atmosphere, which is the air component, hydrosphere, the liquid component, lithosphere, which is the soil component, and biosphere, which contains the living and non-living components as a whole, mainly the living components. Then the syllabus also interestingly involves laws of thermodynamics so that you can understand the heat transfer, and that is also separately listed as heat transfer processes. Then you have to have a basic understanding of mass and energy transfer. Then the second set of the first unit, if you look at it, it is having meteorological parameters. Meteorological parameters means weather parameters. So what are the different issues? Pressure, temperature, precipitation, humidity, mixing ratio, saturation mixing ratio, radiation, wind velocity. Then here you have adiabatic lapse rate, environmental lapse rate. Adiabatic lapse rate we will again see in air pollution. So here also you have the basic introduction to adiabatic lapse rate. Then you have the environmental lapse rate. So these things are useful for understanding how much or how long a particular environmental pollution is staying in the environment. Then you have the concept of wind roses. And if you look at the third aspect of the unit 1, which is the fundamentals of environmental sciences, it understands the interaction between earth, man and environment. Then you have to learn a little bit about biogeographic provinces which are present in the world. Throughout the world, what are the different biogeographic provinces? These will determine what kind of environment and what kind of organisms are surviving there. Then we learn about in India, what are the different agroclimatic zones. Then you also learn about the concept of sustainable development. So making the resources available for the future generations to come, that is sustainable development. So second module, second set of modules, if you look at it, it includes the natural resources. First is assessment of the natural resources, where you assess what kinds of natural resources are there. Then you have remote sensing. So remote sensing and GIS means geographical information system. So the basic principles of remote sensing and GIS you have to learn. In that, you have to learn about little bit about digital image processing techniques and also about ground truthing techniques. So this is the first set. Then the next set is also related to this, where you look at the applications of remote sensing and GIS. GIS, again, I will tell you, it is geographical information system. Under this, you have planning and management. So, if you look at the syllabus as such in the UGC website, it has not split the syllabus into this format. I have made it like this so that you can follow the syllabus easily and use it to plan your study schedule. So, this is applications. Under applications, you have planning and management. Under planning and management, you have land cover planning and management, and you have land use planning and management. Then we come out of this concept and go into urban sprawling, which is the concept of urban population which is extending from the urban into the rural areas. So you have urban sprawling, and also a little bit about how remote sensing and GIS is used in vegetation studies. So it can be used for studying the urban sprawling, it can be used for studying vegetation studies, it can be used in forestry, and it can be used in identification or study of natural resources which are present in the country or in any geographical location. So after these two modules, you can see the third module I have given, there are some general topics. It is environmental education, environmental awareness, and environmental ethics. So these are the final three modules for Unit 1. Unit 1 is the fundamentals of environmental sciences, and these are the concepts or the topics which you have to become thorough in order to be able to answer any questions that come from Unit 1. Okay, thank you, and do not forget to subscribe to this channel. I will also be posting the syllabus reviews of the other units which will be available in this same channel. Okay, thank you very much. Bye-bye.